two brandy and soda, please.
Just out of reach. Time has changed you, I can see. Try to remember how we used to be. Come on back to me. Just out of reach. Don't stand back and you will see just how easy it can be. But you stand contentedly.
That's better.
I'm not very good at drinking on an empty stomach.
Did you ever have an imaginary friend when you were a child, Miss Lake?
Did Stephen tell you that?
In a way. What sort of a friend was it?
A little girl. Didn't you ever have an imaginary playmate when you were little?
I was raised amidst the strife and tumult of 9 male and female siblings. It would have been madness to invent a death.
Did Stephen tell you my playmate's name?
No, I didn't.
Funny. Does that seem odd to you?
Compared to most oddities that fall into my professional lap, it's downright commonplace.
Bunny was the name of a character in a child's storybook. She was a lovely character, so I named my playmate after the girl in the book. Then later, when my daughter was born, I called her Bunny as a nickname. Isn't that what you're really questioning me about?
I'm not questioning you, Miss Lake. I'm just trying to know you better. What happened to the Bunny in the storybook? How did her story end?
I can't remember.
Well, what happened to the bunny you invented?
When I began to outgrow her, we decided it would be better if she died and went to heaven.
We?
Stephen and I. He had read about this Buddhist funeral ceremony they have each year in Japan for broken dolls. So we dug a grave in the garden, and then we buried her after burning all of her things.
What things?
The imaginary things an imaginary child would need.
What the hell do you think you're doing, Newhouse?
Mr. Lake.
Well, the superintendent was being so charming to you here, his stooges have been searching our apartment. I assume you have a search warrant.
Are you making a complaint?
Why are you pouring liquor into my sister when you know she's so upset? Was he trying to brainwash you?
Oh, Stephen, of course not.
What are you up to, Newhouse?
Trying to find the truth.
Is that what you were looking for in our apartment?
I just want to find one simple thing. One small, simple proof.
Proof of what?
That Bunny Lake exists.
Son of a...
Let him go. We're not supposed to hit you, Mr. Lake. In return, I must ask you not to hit me. It really doesn't prove anything.
Mr. Newhouse, what are you going to do now?
Nothing's changed now.
Go home.
When I saw you again, little girl, something stopped here inside and I wanted...